Hi, Charity Simmons, PSP fitness instructor and 200-hour yoga instructor from Cold Lake Air Base. Today I'm going to be doing a yin class for you, focusing on opening those hips. If you want to grab a block or a bolster, feel free. You don't require it, but if you'd like to go get one, go ahead. I do have some knee pads I will be using. If you don't have knee pads, you can either roll up your mat or use a towel or a blanket. So go ahead and get your equipment. I'm just going to start in seated butterfly, but please feel free to go get water or any equipment, a blanket, anything you require. Sitting nice and tall, lengthening your spine, soles of the feet together. Choices with your hands can be on your thighs, palms facing up or down. Or you can interlace your fingers between your toes to give your toes a little bit of space. So always remember, this is your practice. Find your variation of the pose. Relax your neck, your shoulders, finding your breath. Sitting as tall as you can, lengthening and breathe. You can choose to close your eyes here if you like. If your eyes are open, try to soften them. Try not to look at anything in particular. Just relax your gaze and breathe. staying in butterfly. I want you to inhale, lengthen, and on your exhale, let your stomach go, round your back, tuck your chin. Dropping your head, you can find stillness with your neck, or you can give me little yes, no's with your neck. Really let the stomach go, breathe. Slowly sitting up tall again, staying in butterfly. Lengthen your spine, shoulder blades down and back, chin off your chest, and breathe. Again with your hands, if you want to interlace your fingers between your toes, give your toes some space. If you want your hands on your thighs, palms up or down, one up, one down. And place your hands on your stomach, wherever you like. You can give yourself a little self-massage into your neck, if you like, or just find stillness. Thank you. quick movements. I'm going to place my hands behind my back, palms to the earth. Slowly bring those knees together. You can assist them if you need to. And then straighten out your legs. Chest up nice and high. Lean back. Eyes to the light. You can just find stillness here with your legs. Or if you want to kind of give them a little bounce, feel free. Always remember this is your practice. Listen to your body. Slowly I'm going to make my way into resting child's pose. This is where you can use these soft pads for your knees if you'd like, or if you want to use a rolled up towel or blanket. I'm going to have my legs wide because I'm really trying to work on that groin area today, opening up my hips. If you decide if you need a break, feel free to have those knees together. So my big toes are together, my knees are wide, my arms are extended out, lengthened out in front of me. If this is hard on your elbows and your shoulders, feel free to soften your arms a little bit. You can place your head right onto the earth, a block, a bolster. You can stack your fists one on top of the other and place your head on that. Again, always just find your variation of the pose. Again, no quick movements. Take your time getting in and out of the poses. And you're going to make your way onto your back. Knees bent, heels by your bum. You can cactus or tee out your arms to the sides. Try to open up that chest, having your hands on your stomach. And on your chest feels really good, and that's fine too, whatever your variation is. But if you do sit in front of a computer all day, try to open up that chest. Just let your knees drift from side to side, nice and slow. Relaxing your neck, your face. When your knees drift to the right side, just let them fall wherever they fall. If you want to place a bolster, block, or anything under your knees, feel free. And then if your back and neck are okay with it, let your head drift to the left side. Chin falls towards the shoulder. Bring your head back to center. Slowly bring those knees back. Just readjust your back and your bum and your neck. And then again, letting the knees drift from side to side, nice and slow. And when they go to the left side, let them fall down to the earth and let your chin drop to that right shoulder this time.
back to center. Slowly bring those knees back to center. And again, if you need to readjust your bum and your back, then go ahead and bring those knees in towards your chest into cannonball. Your head and shoulders can be on or off the mat. You can choose stillness or kind of a roll from side to side or back and forth, whatever feels good for that back. Bringing your feet back down to the earth, knees are bent. Again, you can do cactus or teed arms, opening up that chest. And then we're gonna do a butterfly. So letting those knees fall out to either side, soles of the feet together. So adjust your feet either closer or farther away from your groin area. Try to relax the shoulders, your neck, and breathe. You can always use a bolster or blocks underneath your knees to prop them up if required. And slowly bringing those knees together. Keep your knees bent as you heel toe your feet off the mat and let your knees fall in the other direction, so towards each other. Thank you. slowly widening your knees. Walk your feet together. And then one more time into butterfly. Soles of the feet together. Letting both knees belong to either side. Slowly bringing those knees together and then making your way into Savasana. Try to lengthen your spine, sinking deeper into that mat. Palms to the sky, letting the feet fall out to either side. Finding your breath. I'm going to leave you here in Savasana. Please feel free to stay as long as you like. Thank you for practicing with me. Namaste.